today's lectures. Today we'll see deviation of real gases from ideal gas behavior. So in this topic, as we have previously discussed, that what is the real gases and what is the ideal gases, what is the difference between these two gases. So now we'll see how this real gases will deviate from the ideal gas behavior. In terms of behavior means how they will behave differently with pressure, increasing pressure, temperature and volume. Actually, no gas is ideal or perfect in nature. So under ordinary conditions, only those gases nearly behave as ideal or perfect which have very low boiling point, like nitrogen, hydrogen. So these two gases, not only two gases, there are so many gases which have low boiling point. A real gas is one which actually exists whether it obeys gas law strictly or not. That we have already discussed, real gases which obey gas law strictly. Gas law means that we know Charles law, Boyle's law. So real gases obey gas equation only approximately and also at low pressure and high temperature. So it will behave like a ideal gas at approximately level. Means when the condition is at low pressure and high temperature, then this real gas will behave as a ideal gases and they will follow the gas laws of ideal gases. So this is the important condition for the behavior of real gases at these conditions. Gases generally deviate at high pressure and low temperatures. So if you keep the conditions high pressure and low temperature, it will deviate. So how it will deviate, that we are going to see today. The most easily liquefiable and highly soluble gases like ammonia, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, they will show large deviation. So these gases will show large deviation. How they will see large deviation, that we are going to see in the form of graph. So graph is drawn by the scientists like Reynolds, Andrew and Amager. They studied the effect of change of the pressure on the volume of different gases at constant temperature as well as different temperature ranges. So they plotted pressure volume against the pressure at a constant temperature. So what they plotted graph, this is the graph you can see here. So this is the graph of real gas, this is the ideal gas. You can see this is the graph, dotted line is the structure of the graph of ideal gases and this is the graph of the real gases. So if you see here, so at this point what happens, the volume of the real gases becomes larger but the volume of the ideal gas becomes lower. This is the P axis, this is the volume axis. Similarly, we can draw this graph in the form of volume pressure. So volume pressure means this will go reverse up. So here you can see it. So volume of the real gases become large, volume of the ideal gas becomes smaller. So this is the difference of this one. We can draw one more graph in terms of pressure temperature. You can see here, this is pressure temperature. This is the ideal gas straightly, they are following this ideal, but temperature they won't follow. They will start from here. So this temperature will be highest, then it will go constant with the parallel with the ideal gases. So this is the difference between pressure volume pressure and pressure temperature graph. Here we can also see, this is your pressure volume NRT, this is your pressure. So this is called as a compressibility factor, that is equal to 1. So 1 means Z equal to P equal to NRT. 1 means this graph will be, this dotted line will show the behavior of ideal gases. But with this ideal gas, there are so many different gases also there. So you can see this graph is, some graph is going very down. This is for ammonia, this is for carbon dioxide, this is for methane gas. And followed by methane gas, this is your nitrogen. Then you can see hydrogen, they can make a helium. So hydrogen, helium showing a straight line. But you can see this is a deep of the curve. This is a deep of the curve is showing ammonia. This is means, what is the meaning of Z is less than 1? What is the meaning of Z is more than 1? Z is more than 1 means the gases cannot be compressible like hydrogen, helium. So above this line, the gas, when gas reaches this level, this is the pressure point. So these are the pressure points. These points are pressure. In this way, if you give this much pressure, the gas cannot be compressible. And this will be always in gaseous state. But if the graph is going below this line, means Z equal to 1, then this graph can be compressible. So among all the gases, you can see ammonia is too much compressible, followed by carbon dioxide and followed by this is your methane. So methane is your less compressible as compared to carbon dioxide, ammonia. Ammonia is too much compressible. So in this pressure, it is easily compressible, but when you increase the pressure, so you can see the it becomes incompressible. So this is the deviation, actually deviation. Let us understand more through this conclusions. So the deviation of real gases from the ideal gas behavior is explained in terms of compressivity factor, that is called Z equal to PV equal to PV by nRT, and it is expressed mathematically. So this is expressed mathematically. For ideal gas, we are assuming that is Z equal to 1, that is in this cases PV equal to nRT, but for real gases Z is not equal to 1, or we can say PV is not equal to RT. This compressivity factor can also expressed as Z equal to V real by V ideal. So in this real gases Z is not equal to 1. What is the meaning of Z is not equal to 1? Z when greater than 1, it will show positive behavior, means it will be less compressible. As we have seen in the previous picture, it was less compressible like carbon dioxide ammonia. But if Z is equal to less than 1, then gas will show negative deviation, means that gas will be more compressible. So I have drawn the graph of hydrogen, helium, nitrogen, methane and carbon dioxide previously. From that you can compare it. So what are the observations from the plotted curve? So this, from the plotted curve, you can see there is no real gases which gives a straight line parallel to x-axis. A straight line, no, there some are giving not parallel, they are making slope. Like hydrogen, helium, they are making slope. Four gases, nitrogen, this is methane. So nitrogen, methane, carbon dioxide, etc. At low pressure, the deviation was negative. So you can see in the previous graph, it was negative. The value of Z increases with increasing pressure. So when the value of Z was increasing with increasing pressure, so when you increase in pressure, it was increasing. So if you remember, the graph was like this one. This is the ideal gas. It was increasing like this one. You can see it was increasing. So here, this is the pressure axis. This is the PV axis. This was the PV axis. So at a different pressure, the gas behave as a ideal, and at high pressure, it will show positive deviation. So if you increase in the pressure, it was showing the positive deviation. So this was the negative deviation, this was the positive deviation that we have seen in the previous graphs. For hydrogen, helium, Z was greater than 1. So for hydrogen, if you go the back, it was the, so this was the hydrogen, this was the helium, this was the hydrogen, this was the graphs. So this is showing the positive deviations. Effect of pressure, so if you take at very low pressure, PV equal to nRT when Z is equal to 1. So what happens if you take very very low pressure? In this cases, Z is almost approximately equal to 1. Mean this will show that those type of gases will show ideal gas behavior. But if you take at low pressure, means more than the very low pressure, then Z will show it will be less than 1. Less than 1 means it will be the gas will be compressible, means that gas will be more compressible than ideal gases. In this case, volume of real gas will be lesser than the volume of the ideal gas. What does this mean? This means it means attractive force will dominate the repulsive forces. Carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide are easy to be easily liquefied and possess high solubility in water or have a higher critical temperature. This is important point. So this will show higher solubility in water and have a higher critical temperature, and show negative deviations than other gases, such as nitrogen, oxygen, which have lower value of critical temperature. So these gases having a lower value of critical temperature, so they are highly solubility in water. In all such cases like CO2 and SO2, value of pressure volume decreases with increasing pressure till PV passes through the minimum, and with further increase of pressure, the compressibility is less than the expected, that is PV increases. However, lower than that of required Boyle's law. However, lower than that required for the Boyle's law with increasing pressure. So already we in the graph we have seen. So graph was, if you see again, remember this was the ideal gas graph, and you can see the graph was drawn like this one. So in this case, if the curve is going up, so pressure is what decreasing. When pressure is decreasing, then the compressivity factor was increasing. So after passing through the minimum, so this was the minimum value. So when this passes this minimum value, till passes through the minimum value. So when you pass through the minimum, the pressure volume decreases. So definitely, it is decreasing. When you go, so it is decreasing with increase in pressure. So on increase, it is decreasing. Here it is decreasing. First it is decreasing, then passes through the minimum with increase of pressure.